Earth, otherwise known as the world, in Greek, Gaia, or in Latin, Terra, is the third planet from the sun. It is the densest planet in the solar system, and, as far as we know, it is the only home to life in the universe. Why? What is it that makes our planet so special? The answers are hidden deep in the Earth's past. To find them, we must travel back in time until we reach the birth of the Earth itself. Then we can piece together our planet's incredible story and discover why all of this, all of us, are here. Humans evolved. Tiny mineral grains in space clumped together to form the molten ball that became the Earth. But exactly when that happened is a question that has taxed the minds of scholars and scientists for centuries. Modern radiometric techniques have defined the age of the Earth to a remarkable degree of accuracy. Most recent studies show that Earth formed 4.54 billion years ago, plus or minus 0.05 billion years, by gradual accumulation from the solar nebula and the mass of dust and gas. exactly did the Earth form? Investigations indicate that billions of rocks gradually grew as they orbited around the Sun, first to the size of boulders, then as big as houses. The young Earth had so much gravitational pull that it began to attract bigger and bigger objects. As they crashed onto its surface, Earth's size increased with every impact. The newborn Earth was made of billions of pieces of rock, randomly stuck together. And the process was so accelerated that it took only about 30 million years for the planet to grow to almost its present size. Imagine a totally molten world with molten magma oceans. There was no dry land anywhere, no water, just flowing lava everywhere. The temperature of the molten Earth, a staggering 2,000 degrees. Of the planet, the vacuum of space is a constant minus 450 degrees, almost 2,500 degrees cooler. The surface rock cannot stay molten for long. It cools from the outside in. So the outside begins to crust over and get scabs like those on a wound. In less than a million years, the Earth's surface was covered in a thin crust. But volcanoes still spewed out lava and choking gases. Thank you. is busy with how different types of rock can reveal the underlying secrets of the formation of our planet.
There is still so much that we do not understand about what is happening on the surface of the Earth. It's truly fascinating and overwhelming. I found myself entangled in all those enormously huge questions. So I decided to look for answers deep beneath the surface of the Earth, layer by layer, to see how things function. That they do function at all, that this is important, that we all are part of a mind-blowing plan to get some clarity, to finally solve the big why, to get it out of the way. So that I can live my life, my day-to-day, nice life. I like to think of Earth as a living organism. Breathing, aging, made up of layers, with a surface that is flexible and perforated like skin, cool on the outside and hot and stinky on the inside. And the deeper you go, the darker it gets.
Thank you.
first, Earth was molten, with temperatures in the thousands of degrees. But in the cold vacuum of space, this hot rock began to cool and change. Nothing, not a speck of dust, is believed to have survived from that period. It was a hellishly unpleasant time. Volcanoes spewed hot lava from deep inside the planet. Alexander has spent the last 5 years of his career collecting impact evidence and creating realistic reconstructions of the late heavy bombardment.
Really hard in order to recreate this early phase in Earth's development. And it's not as easy as you might think to reconstruct. I've been working with all different kinds of materials. It's really a matter of scale and proportion. Sometimes it's so small that you cannot even see what you're working with. Other times, it's larger than the room and the space you're in. Sometimes, it's so fast that your eye cannot catch it. And other times, it just does not trigger anything for the imagination. And every time you look at it, it changes right in front of your eyes.
Stories this planet can tell us is where all our water came from and how it got here. At the time the Earth was forming, the inner solar system was too hot for liquid water to exist. The nearest water reserves in our solar system were 260 million kilometers away in the outer asteroid belt. But how the water could travel from that distance to the Earth is a mystery scientists are only just beginning to solve.
Older and about to throw away some childhood memories, I found that piece and did some research and read that meteorites, at least some of them, contain salt and water, the very same that we have on Earth. Means meteorites brought all the water down from outer space, drop by drop, until we had oceans. Like, imagine the myriads of meteorites and all the time it must have needed to bring all that water down here on Earth. The very same water that even we consist of. My body is at least like 60% water. Water that came from outer space. Amazing, huh? So, having this information, the big question is, how do I feel? Do I feel privileged or tiny? Important? overwhelmed or insignificant. Moist. Old. Should I feel sad or happy? Professional. Precious. Speechless.
puts them in plastic bags, labels them, has them neatly organized, then messes them up, just to see what happens. Is it life that he is after? Can life be created under artificial conditions? And if so, what kind of life would it be? And once he stumbles upon it, will he even recognize it as life?
I let a mass mess with my face. I let a mess with my face. I like to mess with things. Mess with things, mess with things. In the back. Shoot them up, shoot them up, shoot them up. Oh, make your funny shapes. Falls into cars, into cars.
Thank you.
Studies suggest that all life on Earth emerged from primitive cellular colonies. But how did those first reproducing creatures come about? Even the simplest bacteria alive today are far too complex to have popped into existence in a single step. The first reproducing creature could not have developed through biological evolution, because biological evolution requires reproduction in order to work. The most promising idea right now is that life emerged from chemistry. High energetic chemical reactions are thought to have produced building blocks like amino acids and sugars, turning into self-replicating molecules.
To make life appear. You just need a certain temperature. The building blocks, hydrogen, nitrogen, they were everywhere in space to be found. So the final ingredient is time. A bit of pressure. And then things that were quite apart from each other finally come together. Sometimes organically, sometimes suddenly, like a rock in your head. So, what other ingredients and conditions do we need ideally? We know that we need it moist. We need it hot. We need it sticky. Eventually, it becomes sweet. And it might start as a superficial meeting. But given the ingredients of time and pressure and maybe low lights and some music, it might turn into a deep encounter which needs small structures to merge and evolve into bigger and bigger conglomerates.
when interrupted by mass extinction events. Earth's biodiversity has continually expanded. Although scholars estimate that over 99% of all species that ever lived on Earth are today extinct, there are an estimated 14 million species still in existence, of which over 86% have not yet been described. Thank you.
Hi. I'm Alex. And I'm one of the unicellular creatures here. And as I was rolling around here, I suddenly felt quite dizzy. And then this thought crossed my mind. What am I doing here? You know, I tried to adapt, to fit in. Does that mean doing the same like everyone else? Or do I change everything around me so that it suits my needs? Or should I get changed so that I suit my environment? Do I even like the environment? Does the environment like me? That's maybe beyond the common unicellular thought. It's not really something one single cell needs to be busy with, right? Maybe I'm getting ahead of myself. Sometimes I just ask myself, why? You know? Why? We know so many things. We know that there is a last universal common ancestor, the most recent organism from which all organisms on the planet have a common descent. And we know now that life originated under conditions found in deep sea vents, where ocean water interacts with magma erupting through the ocean floor. And we can now describe the last universal ancestors' internal mechanisms in terms of DNA, amino acids, ATP, ion pumps, cellular division, chemiosmosis, and we can now identify a set of 355 genes which all life on Earth has in common. We know so many things. Yes, a few things might still be unresolved, but what happens when we find those out? What happens? Then we will say, now we know. Now we know that we are love's emotion, restlessly drifting around in the ocean.
nut you're adding with this piece of rock!
Yeah. And in the meantime, we're still driven by the same mechanisms of how do I get what I want? How do I keep you from getting what you want? How do I satisfy my needs?
Procreate! We need to procreate! There's not enough of us yet. We need to be more and make bigger structures and superstructures so that we can expand and multiply. These are little creatures surviving on evolution. Because dying out.
Back where we all came from, because we are all made of star stuff.
How do you hear me? Can you hear me?